Glory, hallelujah, praise the name of the Lord. Today I pray that God will empower you to overcome stress. Whatever is stressing you is removed right now by the blood of Jesus. Receive power to overcome stress. You will not be stressed to sick. You will not be stressed to sudden death. You will not be stressed to drop down dead suddenly. In the name of Jesus, let the stress in your life be removed by the word of God right now. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. This is Joseph Adenuga again, the pastor of Prevailing Church. I'm here, as usual, to bring you the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, to bless you and to establish you in the faith. Hallelujah. Today, as usual, I'm going to continue that topic which I started some 3 days ago, which I titled Destroying Negative Pronouncements. You see, I've been on this. If you have not listened to them, they are very important for you to listen to. Destroying Negative Pronouncements. If you are receiving this on WhatsApp, for the last 3 days, I've been talking about it. This is the fourth episode of Destroying Negative Pronouncements. I want to advise you to go back and listen to the first three messages, because that will help you to fully understand what I am about to say in this episode. And if you don't have any of those, you don't have, maybe you didn't receive, maybe this is your first time of receiving this message, then go to our website, www.triggersforsuccess.com. Four as in figure four. Triggersforsuccess.com. Go there, search for Destroying Negative Pronouncements 1, 2, and 3. Listen to them. Then come back and listen to this. It's going to make a full meaning to you when you begin to listen to this one. When you have listened to the first three. Hallelujah. See, in the last episode, I'm talking about destroying negative pronouncement by pronouncing the word of God or confessing the word of God. You see, in the last episode, I'm trying to let you understand that the Bible called Christianity the great profession. Christianity is our profession. Hebrews chapter 3, verse 1 is talking about we keep on our profession. We must keep our profession, which is our confession. You see, we must continue to confess the word of God. It is the reason why God told Joshua in the book of Joshua chapter 1, verse 8. He said, look, man, if you want to succeed, this book of the law must not depart out of your mouth. See what God is saying, out of your mouth. The book of the law, which is the word of God, must not depart from your mouth. You see, it did not say it must not depart from your heart. No, it must not depart from your heart, but because when it comes from your heart to your mouth, it's really when it works. The word of God must dwell in your heart. You see, Colossians chapter 3, verse 16 says, let the word of God dwell richly in you, in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and spiritual songs, singing with melody in your heart. Hallelujah. So the word of God must not just be in your heart, it must be in your mouth. You must confess it. When you confess the word of God daily, all the negative pronouncements that has been made against you, or that you have made against yourself, or that you have made against other people that came back to you, all those negative pronouncements will be neutralized by the word of God. You see, the word of God is a neutralizer of negative words. Because you see, in John chapter 1, reading from verse 1, the Bible says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was light, and the light was the life of men, and the light shines in darkness, and the darkness does not comprehend it. And verse 14 says, and the word became flesh. Jesus is the word. When you speak the word of God, the word of God is alive. You see, the written word of God, the logos, is the living word. The word of God is living, but it cannot be alive until you speak it. When you read it, it is not yet living. It becomes living in you when you begin to speak it. When you speak the word, the word will come alive. But when you read the word will bless you. But it does not come alive until you speak it. When you speak the word of God, negative pronouncements against you are neutralized by the word. Because the word will express what you speak it, especially if you speak it from your heart. That's why Romans chapter 10, from verse 9 and 10, he said, if you shall confess with your mouth Jesus Christ as Lord, and you shall believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Meaning salvation comes when you proclaim Jesus as Lord, and when you believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, that is when salvation comes. That means that salvation comes by two things. By believing in your heart and proclaiming with your mouth. So when you speak the word of God from your heart and you proclaim it in your mouth, it will do what God says it will do. The word of God can do what God says it will do. In the book of Isaiah chapter 55, He says, the words that I speak unto you, they shall not return to me void. They shall accomplish that thing where I send it. The word of God accomplishes what God speaks. So when you speak the word of God, it must come to pass. The word of God never fails. The word of God is the neutralizer of curses. Has anybody cursed you in your life? Then the solution is the word of God. Because the word of God will naturally displace the word of a man. Hallelujah. The word of God is higher than any other word. So the word of God takes preeminence over every other word. And that is what I want to say to you. If you have spoken a negative word against anybody, that negative word may come back to you. So neutralize it with the word of God. First of all, tell God, Lord, I'm sorry for speaking against so and so person. Maybe you are one of those that used to speak against the man of God, against the prophets of God. If you see any prophets doing any form of miracle, never join your mouth to talk against them. You see, because when somebody is doing miracle in the name of Jesus, no matter how you don't understand his life, don't speak against him. If you have spoken against anyone like that, you need to first of all say, Lord, I am sorry. I have spoken against so and so a man of God. I am sorry for speaking against him. Forgive me. God will forgive you and forget about it. Hallelujah. And those negative pronouncements which you have spoken against that person will not come back as a curse to you again because you have repented. If need be, if you can assess that man, if you can see that man, you can say to that man, sorry, man, I'm sorry, there was a time I didn't understand your ministry and I spoke against you, but forgive me, I've asked God to forgive me. He will be happy, he will forgive you because he's a man of God. Hallelujah. So it is very important for you to understand. Haven't done that, but all those negative words that anybody has spoken against you will be naturally neutralized when you begin to confess the word of God. For instance, the word of God says, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Hallelujah. I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. When you wake up in the morning and you proclaim, I can do all things, that day, everything will become easy. You will have power to do anything that you want to do. When you wake up in the morning and you say, by the stripes of Jesus, I am healed. Sicknesses and diseases in your body will clear off. When you wake up in the morning and you say, but my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. No matter what curse anybody have placed upon you concerning finance, that curse will be neutralized. Hallelujah. The word of God is powerful. Oh, time has gone. This way I'm going to stop. Thank you so much for listening. I'd like you to rebroadcast this. Get somebody blessed by sending them this word and let them listen to this and be blessed as you are blessed by this word. Thank you so much for listening. I pray that the blessings of God that make rich will be added to you every day of your life in Jesus' name. This is Joseph Adenuga signing out and saying, be blessed and remain blessed.